The first part of this lab is a tool introduction, shown in a different video. This video will show you in some detail how to build a launcher undercarriage. Please work in pairs to make one per bench. Goggles are mandatory. Bring your own or use the ones we provide. Work from your lab handouts. Examine the samples we have, and if you want, you can install software to look at 3D models on your own computer. To get started, decide who makes what in between the two of you. Use these paper templates to lay out and cut your parts as precise as you can. Make good use of all the different tools you have available. And it's a good idea to keep your workplace clean, both on your workbench and on the ground. Keep an eye out especially for sharp pieces. Don't let them sit on your bench for a long time. When you're ready for bending, draw bend lines using the dimensions from the sketches. Bending itself is very tricky. You have to plan ahead, and there's one more tool in the lab that you can use. It's called a pan and box brake. It makes it easy to bend long and straight lines, and it can even bend more complex shapes as long as they are not too tall. There's often more than one solution to do bends, and maybe you can find better ways than the ones shown in this video. As we move along, we'll show fewer and fewer details on what exactly you have to do. Now that you know how to use your tools, you can decide for yourself which method to use to make your parts. Nuts and bolts are normally used to assemble things. We don't have these for the launcher. Instead, we use plastic parts as fasteners as well as rivets. The plastic fasteners are black plastic rod and red rubber tubing, and they can easily be cut to any length. The black plastic can be cut with needle nose pliers and the red rubber with scissors. Using this technique, you can fabricate linkages, hinges, and many other things. You can use them as standoffs to hold the Arduino board and even make rubber feet that won't slip. Once you add the arm to your undercarriage, use plastic fasteners to test your best position for your servo motor. You will need to decide what range of motion you want your arm to have. And eventually, you can use rivets for solid attachment. To connect your servo to the arm, make a small linkage from wire using Z-bend pliers. There's a lot of slack or play in this connection here. Play is bad for precision, but there are usually ways to reduce it to a minimum. And now it's time to start thinking about the other parts of your launcher.